Couple in the holy bonds of matrimony, which is declared by the word of God to be honorable among all men. God himself integrated the wedding ceremony when in the very beginning of human history he saw it was not good for man to be alone and made a woman helpmate for him. Jesus, the Son of God, gave his sanction when in the very beginning of his ministry he attended the wedding feast of Cana of Galilee and performed there his first miracle. It is therefore not to be entered lightly but reverently in the fear of God. Let's pray. Father, as we come before you on this gorgeous day, we just pray, Lord, that your hand of blessing would be upon this relationship. That, Father, that they would put you in the center of their relationship. Help them, Lord, as they grow together, to grow closer to you. Thank you for all the family and friends today. We just pray that you would, Father, honor and be glorified in Jesus' name. Amen. Who doth give this woman to be wed? We're going to have a special song at this time. David's granddaughter. Thereof, and the rib which the Lord God taken from man made a woman, and brought her unto man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. If you, David, and you, Korah, you realizing the importance of this decision in the light of God's holy word, and have freely and deliberately chosen each other in this holy estate, and know of no just cause why you should not be so united, in token thereof, please join your right hand. David, you take this woman whom you hold by the right hand to be your lawful wedded wife. Do you promise to love her, to honor her in that relationship, and leaving all others to cleave only unto her, and to be to her a true and faithful husband as long as you both shall live? Or, do you take this man whom you hold by the right hand to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise to love him, to honor him, and cherish him in that relationship, and leaving all others to cleave only unto him, and to be to him a true and faithful wife as long as you both shall live? In keeping with this decision, you now declare your betrothals. Please repeat after me. I, David, take thee, Korah, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness or in health, till death do us part. And thereto, I give thee my love. I, Korah, take thee, David, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness or in health, till death do us part. And thereto, I give thee my love. Okay? You can tell the other one. You want me to go back? Okay. We read in the sacred record that when God made a covenant with Noah, he set a rainbow and the cloud thereof, and said in Genesis 9:16, and I will look upon it and remember the everlasting covenant. Thus we may learn it as well when we enter to some solemn agreement with one another to set aside some reminders of what you have promised. What tokens do you present of your marriage covenant? Yes, I want. All right, let's pray. Once again, we come before you, Lord. We thank you for this precious dream. That each time that they look down at these dreams, they're reminded of the promises that they have made before you, first and foremost, before all their peers and family. I just pray now that your hand of blessing would be upon these rings. In Jesus' name, amen. David, put upon his third finger for his left hand. Repeat after me. With this ring, I do thee wed, and with all my worldly goods, I thee endow. Lord, put upon the third finger of David's left hand and repeat after me. Put upon the solemn nervous, third finger, left hand. Repeat after me. With this ring, I do thee wed, and with all my worldly goods, I thee endow. Okay, for as much then you have covenanted together according to the teachings of God's holy word and compliance with the laws of the state of Pennsylvania, I charge you to hope for happiness in married life, the truth of the vows you've taken, you now begin life under new conditions and larger responsibilities, and only by faithfully performing the duties and fulfilling the obligations of this new relationship that you and lasting happiness can be found. I now pronounce you man and wife, and you kiss your bride, David. Yeah. Proverbs 18:22 says, whosoever findeth a wife findeth a good thing, obtaineth favor from the Lord. And the other thing I want to say is, in Matthew 19:6, let me hold this up. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present to you Mr. and Mrs. David Ahern.
Turned out good.
That's the picture right there.
Be careful how far you
turn. Just don't wear my dress. I feel the heat.
Put your hand down a little.
Don't trip, Dave.
I can see the heat coming off of it.
The dress is starting to smoke.
your turn, Cora.
Yeah, I'm bringing you.
Stand a little
closer, though. Oh, yeah, it is.
How close
are you? Stop moving. She's going for you. It'll be getting hot pretty quick.
Good.